FairPoint is struggling to pay its bills, and the Consumer Advocate's Office says some of the company's customers are so frustrated with the phone and internet problems, they're refusing to pay their FairPoint bills. Those close to all this say restructuring now is the best option for the company because bankruptcy might take the focus away from solving the problems with customer service.
FairPoint's financial wherewithal has been a concern from day one.
We thought that FairPoint would be over-leveraged, that they would have too much debt, and that they were being overly optimistic.
The numbers released in Monday's filing with the Securities Commission are staggering. More than $29 million owed to just one lender, $120 million to another. A third loan has a principal amount of $491 million. And the fourth loan is for $1.3 billion. FairPoint was scheduled to make a payment of $42 million on September 30th, but today's announcement gives the company until October 30th to restructure and try to avoid Chapter 11 bankruptcy.
If we were to enter into a Chapter 11 debt restructuring with or without court supervision, it has no impact on consumers. That is, the network still works, the phones still work, the internet still works. It has very little impact on customers and employees in terms of any kind of distractions.
The state consumer advocate feels that the current restructuring plan is preferable and fears that Chapter 11 bankruptcy would put consumer service issues on the back burner.
And the company agreed to very specific milestones for rolling out more broadband to parts of the state that are just desperate for it. And if their focus is turned to dealing with bankruptcy and dealing with their creditors in litigation, you know, it really takes the focus off of what the customers want FairPoint to be focusing on.
FairPoint is also falling short on delivering broadband services. The goal was 75% by September 30th. The company is fined for each percentage point not achieved. The PUC was unavailable for comment today, but News 9 has learned the commission now has a written transcript from that tri-state meeting back on September 9th, which should lead to some action from the commission soon. Live in the studio tonight, Amy Covino, WMUR News 9.